produced the 300 TDI diesel.
Now, are these rebuilt engines that they do, or are these new engines that he put in?
They're brand new.
Okay. And how many miles is on the new one here?
This one's about 1,200, probably close to 1,500 miles.
So it's not even broke in yet, really?
Yeah, not really.
Not on the diesel.
It's absolutely beautiful in here.
It literally looks like a 2010 vehicle or a 2011 vehicle.
They do a good job.
They do. When we were looking on their website, they do an incredible work.
See, they have a relationship with Land Rover. You know, they're a distributor, a direct distributor of Land Rover. They have a stronger relationship from a manufacturing perspective than a dealership would have or anything like that. They fit these out for expedition.
That's nuts. So on their website, they were showing that they could have a bunch of cross-country additions and stuff like that.
Yeah.
It still has some of the same features that look like the one that I have with the vents in the front here.
Yeah.
So this one has power steering, power brakes.
Yeah.
So what we're on now, doesn't
this,
it?
These are the features that were in that last year before Ford bought them. Ford bought them.
I found the one we're going, the departure, easy to get.
Yeah.
Easy to get.
What's top speed on this one here?
I took it on a 3-hour trip, and I was doing like easily 70, 75, very comfortably.
Yeah. Listen, I mean, our speed limits are 65, so if he's getting 65, that's...
Yeah, but Riser never does the speed limit, Randy.
Now, what most people will do is they'll swap out the a gear kit and take it from a 1.4.
Restored.
Yeah, he's like, it's a good day, it's a good day, it's a good day. Yeah.
Kill it. Say something to your daddy while you're on the TV.
Don't get any better than they have like an undercoating on the sides where they're wearing stuff.
Everything's good. You want to say anything to Austin while you're under there?
You're not gonna like this, Austin.